Hello students, welcome to this class. So we are going to solve a question. We are going to calculate collapse load for multiple span beams. So let's see a question. So here we have to determine collapse load, okay, for a continuous beam. So let's draw a continuous beam. So this is a one end is fixed. One end is fixed here and other it is having a roller support over here. And there is one more roller support over here. There is one load of 40 kilonewton is acting in 3 meter distance and 120 kilonewton load is acting over here. This is the 40 kilonewton, this is the 20 kilonewton. This is 2 meter, the total distance is 4 meter and this particular distance is 2 meter, 3 meter and the remaining distance is 1 meter. This is a support B, this is a support C. Okay. Now here, in a continuous beam as shown in figure, plastic moment capacity of AB is to be kept twice that of BC. Okay, so plastic moment capacity is given as this is twice of this. Now determine the plastic moment capacity of the beam if the loads are as shown in figure and the load factor is 1.5. So the load factor as 1.5 is already given. Now let's find the solution. So let the plastic moment capacity of BC be MP. Let us consider plastic moment capacity. Plastic moment capacity of BC is MP. Hence, the plastic moment capacity of AB will be it will be twice, right? As given in the question. So 2 MP we can write. Now this particular figure shows that the collapse load, it's given in the question the load factor is 1.5, okay? So load given, the collapse load which are 1.5 times the working load. So we can see that there are two collapse mechanisms are possible, one for AB and one for BC, okay? So the beam with collapse load can be shown like this. So two collapse mechanisms are possible. That is here one mechanism and here other mechanism. So we know the beam with the collapse load, right? Now let us draw a collapse mechanism of AB. Collapse mechanism of AB. So here we can write down, okay, for this when you draw a diagram, we can show the collapse mechanism like this. Only for AB we are drawing, okay? So here, this will go below the load. We have to show you, right? We know that bending moment will be maximum below the load. So this is one hinge, this is one hinge, and this is one hinge. Now here we can write it as 2 MP. Here also 2 MP. Here it is 1 MP. Now we know this is theta 1. This is theta 2. So let us label the angle below also. So this is again theta 1, this is theta 2. This is the collapse mechanism for AB. Okay. Now in this figure, when we see this is 3 meter, this is a 3 meter span, okay? For the 3 meter span. This is 3 meter and this is total 1 meter. So the total is 4 meter span. Sorry. There is a slight mistake. This is overall a 4 meter span. Now, when we see above figure, so we can write that internal work done is equal to 2 MP theta 1. We can write that 2 MP theta 1, okay, plus for this part, we can write 2 MP theta 1 plus theta 2. plus mp theta 2. Okay, so with this, this is our internal work done. But we can write that 3 into theta 1 is equal to delta, and which we can write it as 1 into theta 2. Okay, if you see this particular figure, so we can write that 3 into theta 1 equals to delta equals to 1 into theta 2. Okay, this is 3 into theta 1. Why we have written 3 into theta 1? So if you see this, if you draw a line, this is 3 meter. Okay, so 3 into theta 1 into equals to delta equals to 1 into theta 2, because this is 1 meter. So, and this is our delta part. So we can write like this. Okay, so with this we can get the answer as theta 2 is equal to 3 theta 1. So internal work done further we can write it as with the reference of this equation, but where we'll substitute these values. Okay, so we can rewrite the equation as 2 mp theta 1 plus 2 mp theta 1 plus 3 theta 1 plus mp into 3 theta 1. So we get the answer as 13 mp theta 1. Okay, we have substituted theta 2 value here, and here also theta 2 value as 3 theta 1. So when we are done with this, we get the 13 mp theta 1. Now external work done. So equating to external work done, we can write it that 13 mp theta 1 is equal to, yeah, we have missed one step, that it has to be with collapse load. Okay, I have not drawn the collapse load diagram here, so then this step will become difficult. So collapse load factor is given as 1.5. So we have to draw a collapse load diagram. So before I go to this step, just let me draw a collapse load diagram. So collapse load diagram is, means how much load we should consider. So that I am writing here. So collapse load factor is given as 1.5. So multiply the above loads with 1.5. So this is A, this is C, this is support B. So 40 into 1.5 is 60. So give here. So this is 60 kilonewton, and this is 20 into 1.5, that it will become 30 kilonewton. Okay. So I have drawn this beam so that now I can write this equation. So external work done is equal to, now we are seeing the AB portion, right? So it is a 60 kilonewton. So 60 into that deflection, 60 delta. Okay, we can write like this. So we can further write like this, 60 into 3 theta 1. Okay, now when we equate external work done with internal work done, so equate equation number 1 with 2. Equate external work done equals to internal work done. So we get the equation as 13 mp theta 1 is equal to 60 into 3 theta 1. So we get the answer as mp is equal to 13.846 kilonewton meter. Okay, so this is our answer. Now let's see the collapse mechanism of BC. Okay, collapse mechanism of BC. So for that, let the deformed shape of this mechanism be like this. So deformed shape is like this. So this is, at this point, this is 2 mp, this is mp, this is theta, and this part is delta. This is bc, this is 2 meter. Okay, so this is the collapse mechanism for bc. So here internal work done, we can write it as internal work done is equal to mp into theta plus mp into theta plus theta. So we can write like this. So we get the answer as 3 into mp theta. Okay, so this is our answer. Now external work done. External work done is equal to, the load here is 30 kilonewton, right? Collapse load is 30 kilonewton. So 30 into 2 theta. So we get the answer as 60 theta. Now let us equate again the internal work done with external work done. So we can write 3 into mp theta is equal to 60 theta. So with this we get mp is equal to 20 kilonewton meter. So this is our plastic moment capacity. Okay. So the plastic moment capacity for AB is, plastic moment capacity, it is twice, right? Plastic moment capacity for AB is equal to 2 into MP, means 40 kilonewton meter. And for BC, it is 20 kilonewton meter. Okay, students, so hope you have understood this question. The steps are very simple. First, decide the mechanism, okay? So, plastic moment capacity for BC, anyways, it is given in the question that this is twice and this is twice of BC. So, here we have written it as 2MP, here we have written it as MP. So, when we show this mechanism, collapse mechanism for AB, okay? So, we have drawn theta 1, this is theta 2, this is theta 1, theta 2. We have drawn these respective values. Then internal work done, we have to write always, and external work done. Then when we compare, then we get the plastic moment capacity. Okay, so students, hope you this problem is clear to you and you have understood it. Okay, so thanks for listening. Thank you.